If truly life begins at 40, then upon Coach Forex channel hitting 40,000 subscribers, I believe that our journey into the Forex market just begun. What is going on, guys? This is Coach Forex, aka GBP Legend, aka Sniper Trader, aka King of Blues. I really thank you all for being my loyal channel subscribers and then helping us gradually hit that 40,000 subscribers, right? We are on our journey to 100,000. If you're a first time viewer watching this, you gotta be a member of this channel, part of the journey, while we keep gradually growing to hit that 100,000 mark. Now, in appreciation of my loyal subscribers subscribing and then continuously liking, sharing my videos, and then eventually us hitting that 40,000, I have decided to shoot an appreciation video for you guys. Now, basically, that appreciation video is something that I have thought of as so relevant yet less spoken about. In fact, on so many YouTube channels that I've had my time to scroll through in terms of people that shoot trading related content, right? Hardly have I ever seen anybody talk about this pertinent, very crucial thing that I'm about to share with you guys. And I'm doing it out of the love of the support that you guys have continuously been doing it for me. Now, basically, it has everything to do with time frame in the market, right? Now, some people are accustomed to trading the 1 minute time frame, some people 5 minute, 15 minute, 4 hours, whatever it is. But one thing is for sure, and one thing that you guys should know, is that in trading, the higher the time frame, the more relevant the confluence or the confirmation in that trade entry. Now, it may come off a little bit dicey for somebody that has not really been so much accustomed to price action trading. Let me tell you something. I started actually my journey as a trader with using tons of indicators. And then by tons of indicators, I mean that I personally took the time to try every other indicator that we have on the MetaTrader 4, be it the RSI, be it the Bollinger Bands, be it the Ichimoku Kinkoyo, everything you can talk about. So I understand truly the relationship between these indicators and then the market, eventually upgrading my knowledge into pure price action trader without using even a single indicator. Now, what that taught me is by the fact that there is a relationship between price action and then indicators. Very crucial if you're able to understand what I just said. What it means is that if you're a price action trader, you understand the relationship between candles, you know, you can really read into the candles, the confirmations, all the tons of the confirmations out there. And then you are also very exceptionally good at understanding, let's say you're using a moving average crosses, or you're using some stochastics, or you're using Bollinger Bands, the relationship between these price action, which is these key confirmations, and then this moving average you're using, or any other indicator you're using, then you would understand the fact that I am basically talking about the fact that the higher the time frame, the stronger the confirmation. Now, let's not even switch deeper into confusing you guys. What I'm driving at is basically to tell you that we are going to look at a very important time frame in the market that can change a lot in the way you look at the market. In fact, if you're able to get really used to that time frame, right, and then really check it as and when, not just randomly checking it, as and when, it can do you far more good than not in the market. So yeah, to cut the long story short, what we're going to be delving into is basically me revealing to you, like I said in the title, the most important time frame, right? Now, to finally disclose that important time frame is the weekly time frame in the market. Now, I have never, like I said, seen anybody crucially talk about the weekly time frame in the Forex market. If you have been following me, especially on Instagram, which I recommend everybody doing for the past 1 year, right? If you want to follow me on Instagram, it's KOJOFOREX, Kojo Forex. I do a lot of Instagram live sessions where I teach people this kind of content that I'm sharing with you guys for free. If you really want to start trading for any strategy you're using, whether you're using indicators, price action, you really want to start doing your analysis on the weekend, especially on Sunday. Now, why do I say Sunday? It's because by then you would have had the market closing, where we know that the market closes on Friday, and then we are yet to begin a new trading week from Sunday through to Monday to Friday. Now, what that gives you is a good perspective of how the market closed the previous week. Now that you have a good perspective of how the market closed the previous week, with that little knowledge, it can forehand tell you the direction the market is going into in the subsequent week. right? Now let's look at some examples from what I'll be showing you on the screen, and then I think it would be very, very simple and clear to you how to start doing your analysis and then projecting what can happen in a week in any particular trading, right? Now let's look at, let's say, an example from GBP, JPY, right? Now if you look at GBP, JPY, prior to last week, right, look at this. We were basically in a downtrend, right, on the weekly, until we had this big bullish engulfing candle right here, right? Now this is exactly how this thing is going to look like. So as a trader that has seen this on a weekend, knowing that this is exactly how this market closed from the previous week, there is no point in trying to look for a short in the subsequent week, knowing that, like I said in the beginning of my lessons, if you have any idea of candlestick reading, then you are going to understand that the higher the time frame, the stronger the confirmation. Now you have seen a strong bullish closure, which is like the bulls have shown their presence in this market. There is no point to be looking for a short in this. Now let's look at how this will transpire in the subsequent week. Let's put this horizontal ray on the closure just here, right? And then now let's switch to our favorite time frame. Let's say we are accustomed to the 4-hour time frame. This is how the new week is going to look like, right? Now imagine a trader basically seeing that, okay, we have come to the resistance here and then we are likely to go down, right? That's what a lot of people are going to see. That's what a lot of people are going to see, especially people, beginners, intermediates, everybody's going to see, okay, JPY hit this resistance, the next week is going to drop, right? Yes, I reckon that with you and an aside with you, but did you check the weekly? You basically didn't even check how the weekly candle closed. Now let's see practically what happens with this. Literally blows through that resistance and keeps going up. Why? Because we can see from the weekly time frame here that the market had that insane strong closure. So there wasn't any point for you as a trader to reckon that resistance as a means of the market reversing, but anticipating a continuation of that move. You can see that from several currency pairs and then asset classes, right? You can see this sort of a tweezer range happening on this BTC, and then from there we had what, a blast through. We can see some form of a hammer formation here and then a blast through. If you look at Euro USD, we can also see around this range, right, a series of reversal patterns, confirmations telling us what the market is not making any effort to continue its push on the upside, and then from there we've had a continuous push on the downside, right, changing the whole trend. The same thing for Swiss franc, right, Swiss franc Japanese, and after this massive reversal pattern here, a blast through. Now a lot of you have been trying to short the JPY pairs this week, last week, and then I've been staying on the side for a while. Why would you think I've been staying on the side for a while? Because the week is still very strong and very bullish, and I would only start really looking into JPY pair if we have a weekly closure, right? This may sound like a rhythm, but understand me, a weekly closure is only what is going to instigate my decision to start looking for a short. Now weekly closure would mean that I want to see some form of a bearish candle on the weekly closure for most of these JPY pairs, rather than a bullish candle, or some form of a bearish reversal signals. It could be a shooting star, it could be a hanging man, whatever it is. Then I would be now looking for opportunity to start shorting the JPY pair. So I have my eyes on AUD JPY, and I have my eyes also on, let's say, Euro JPY as well, right? So if you look at the weekly, yeah, we're kind of making that kind of pattern or candlestick patterns that is going to influence my decision in looking for a short. We can kind of find the same thing also happening in pound Japanese yen as well. Yes, so if you check pound Japanese yen around here, you can see that we're starting to make some form of a closure indicating a reversal in the trend. So yeah, this is a very simple but detailed short video that I know that is going to change a lot in your perspective if you keenly and steadily follow what I've taught you, right? If you love this content, as usual, you know what to do. Smash the like button, subscribe to this channel if you haven't done that. Click in the link in the description to join the KojoForex Telegram community. Follow me on all social media, KOJOFOREX, and I'll bring you exciting and detailed content like this in my next video. Peace out.